सुखदं केवलं ज्ञानमूर्तिं द्वन्द्वातीतं गगनसदृशं तत्त्वमस्यादिलक्ष्यं एकं नित्यं विमलमचलं सर्वधी साक्षिभूतं भावातीतं त्रिगुणरहितं सद्गुरुं तं नमामि। Nityananda, we welcome all the participants of the session on learning of the Sanskrit Agama Pramanas and Yoga Pramanas with the blessings of His Divine Holiness Bhagavan Sri Nityananda Paramashivam, our most beloved Swamiji. So before we enter into the further aksharas of the Sanskrit Bhasha, let us know how we should do the Achamanam. Yesterday we explained what are all the parts of the Achamanam and how what they mean, etc. Today we'll get to know how we should do the Achamanam. So this is the Panchapatram and the Uddharani. This is the Panchapatram and this is called the Uddharani. So we'll be using only this terms. Now we'll not be using the words cup and the spoon. Okay. So I'll do the Achamanam. So what I did now is, drank the water thrice, pouring the water into the palm with the hand in the Gokarna Mudra, as I explained in the yesterday's session. Now, if you had seen me drinking, I would have put my hand this way and allowed the water to flow into my mouth and then wash my hand with little water. These three we do with the chanting of the mantras. Om Atma Tattvam Shodhayami Swadha. Om Vidya Tattvam Shodhayami Swadha. Om Shiva Tattvam Shodhayami Swadha. These are the three mantras we chant. I'll write it down in the board and I go to the board. Now, after having washed the hand, what we do is wipe the upper and the lower lips with the base of the thumb twice, like, okay, then wash the hand with little water and next with the tips of the index finger, middle finger, ring fingers joined together, touch little above your upper lips, then below your lower lips, with the tips of your right hand, index finger and thumb joined together, touch your right nostril, then left nostril. With the tips of your right hand, thumb and the ring fingers joined together, touch your right eye, right ear, left ear. Then again, wash off your hands with little water. When you wash off your hands with little water, next time you can take the water just this way and just wash off. You can just wash like this. Then with the base of your right hand, thumb and the little finger joined together, touching your navel. You can touch above your clothing itself. You need not remove the clothing and touch. For the female bodies especially. For the male bodies, you will be not wearing your upper cloth. Even if you are not wearing your upper cloth, the navel should be covered. Then your right chest, then left chest, then with all the fingers of your right hand joined together, touching the crown of your head, right shoulder, left shoulder and your heart center. This is the Achamanam, the ritual that we do after the chanting of the Sadguru Vandanam. We do in the Nityananda Yoga. Whether it is the Nityananda Yoga that you do on the floor, or if it can be the Kundalini Raji Yoga that you do on the rope, or it can be the Shivastambha Yoga, Nityananda Shivastambha Yoga that you do on the pole. In all the three, you begin the ritual with the performance of the Achamanam. We welcome all the participants of the Zoom session who are new to this Achamanam to join 6 a.m. Indian Standard Time for the Pratyaksha Paduka Puja that happens live from Adi Kailasa, Bengaluru Adinam, Nityananda Peetam, wherein every day you can join us in these rituals and get trained in these rituals also. Every day 6 a.m. Indian Standard Time, we have the Pratyaksha Pada Puja. It is almost a 45-minute ritual, Pada Puja. You can log on to the nityananda.tv website, or you can log on to Nityananda TV Facebook page, or you can log on to HDH Nityananda Paramashivam Facebook page, where you will have the live streaming of these rituals that happen in Nityananda Peetam, Adi Kailasa every day, through which you can experience intense oneness with Swamiji, Paramashiva himself, and manifest all the powers of Paramashiva just by these rituals. Now, we'll enter into the Aksharas, where we stopped, and simultaneously, we'll also write down the mantras, the three mantras, and the fourth mantra, the mantra with which you wipe your lips. I'll write it on the board. So, we stopped till here yesterday. Ka, kha, ga, gha, nga. Cha, cha, ja, jha, nya. Ta, tha, da, dha, na. Ta, tha, da, dha, na. This is ka, kha, ga, gha, nga, cha, cha, ja, jha, nya, ta, tha, da, dha, na. Ta, tha, da, dha, ना. नेक्स्ट इज प. जूम आउट प्लीज. थैंक यू. प. हाउ यू राइट प? देन पुल डाउन एंड अ स्ट्रोक अबव. प. The next is, you write pa again, the same, and then again bring it up. This is pa and not fa. This is pa and not fa. Then ba. Next is ba. Next is ma. Next is ya. Ra. La. Va. Next is sha. Sa. So these are the vyanjana aksharas of the Sanskrit bhasha. If you see, in the 2 days ago in the session I showed you how your pronunciation you can check. I now will be chanting only the first column. See the movement of my paper. Ka, cha, ta, ta, pa. Now I'll be pronouncing the second column. Ka, cha, ta, ta, pa. Third column. Ga, ja, da, da, ba. Then the fourth column. Gha, gha, ja, dha, dha, bha. The last column. Nga, nya, na, na, ma. All the aksharas of the last column are pronounced with a nasal sound. Nga, like how you say Ganga. That gung is the sound. This is conch. Inch. Inch. That is the sound. This sound is usually not used in English. It is na. For pronouncing the whole row, if this is the this is your upper teeth and lower teeth, upper part of the mouth and lower part of the mouth, you have to keep your tongue little back. Ta, tha, da, dha, na. The tongue needs to be twisted and kept on the back side of the upper palate. In for this whole row, ta, the this is where you keep the tongue. Supposing this is the cross-sectional view of your mouth. This is upper teeth, lower teeth, and gums. Upper roof of your mouth, lower part of your mouth. This is the roof and lower part of your base of your mouth. And the arrow representing the tongue. The tip of the arrow mentioning the tip of your tongue. If you keep it here in the back, it you will be able to pronounce ta, tha, da, dha, na. Next, ta, tha, da, dha, na. Like how you say even though. That sound, though. That's where you keep the lip, your tongue in your mouth. That place, from that place, you pronounce these. This is again ka. The the first column, this first 2, 3, 4, 5. In the 1, 2, 3, and 4 and 5, the same sound is pronounced with the stress, wherein more of prana, air, comes out of your mouth right from your navel when you pronounce the second column of aksharas. For the third column of the aksharas, whatever you pronounce, the same pronunciation is used for the fourth column, but the difference is the fourth column has more stress in pronunciation and more of air, prana, comes out of the mouth. As I showed, if you want to check for yourself whether you are pronouncing it correctly or not, you can use a strip of paper and hold it 1 inch or 2 inch away from your mouth. The from here, you can hold it like here so that the bottom tip of the paper is horizontally equal to your mouth or the lower lip of your mouth. And the with the movement of the paper, you can check whether you, for your own self, whether you are pronouncing these aksharas correctly or not. The pronunciation of these aksharas are extremely important. How you pronounce is extremely important, because as we already said, this bhasha, Sanskrit bhasha, has a phonetic effect. And if you need to experience the right full benefit of using this bhasha, then the pronunciation needs to be correct completely. Coming next, after these 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 rows, next you have ya, ra, la, va. This is not ra. this is not ra, this is ra. Next is sha, next is sha, next is sa, and final one is ha. These two we'll be able to easily pronounce. What is it? How you differentiate first day or second day of the session? I told you how, what is the difference between the pronunciation of this and this. You see a dot here, right? You see a dot here. Same way you see a dot in this whole row. Where you keep your tongue for, you keep your tongue, take it to the back and up, back and touch the upper palate. Same way, bring your, there is a dot below here. So, for pronouncing this, take your tongue to the up, back and touch the upper palate, back side of your upper palate, so that you will be able to pronounce this sha. This is sha, this is sha. If I have to repeatedly say, then you will be able to make the difference in the sound. Sha, 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 sha.